So the guys in U2 are great friends of ours and have been for years and years and years. And Edge was actually a really key element in bringing Jackknife to the R.E.M. camp. As a fan, Edge was like, I think this is the guy. I think this is the guy that you guys need. This is the guy that you need for this record. And he had his whole idea of Edge did, rather, of what this record should be for R.E.M. They're always like kind of they're cheerleading and championing us from the sidelines as friends, and that, you know, that means a lot to me because I really love their band and I really love them as people.
I thought that I heard you laughing. I thought that I heard you sing. I think I thought I saw you try. I ever whispered.
Honestly, the hardest part of it is that I don't think I'd ever been in love before the guy who I'm with now, and I never wanted to say that because the people I was with, I wanted to honor who they were as people, and it was men and women, and that is what it is. But I wanted to honor that, and I didn't want to feel like, I don't know, that crossed the line of privacy for me. And you want to honor a relationship, you want to honor the beautiful parts of it and the things that were great about it, and maybe you weren't seeing eye to eye, or maybe it didn't work out for whatever reasons, but you don't have to dismiss that out of hand or completely. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of my silence was really was not because of how I felt about my sexuality. I was very clear about that with my friends, my family, my band, the people around me. It was more about not dishonoring those who I had relationships with, and that was a lot of people. Spiritual moment. I can think of two. One was on stage and one was backstage. On stage was, of all places, in Boston, at, I think it's called the Wang Center. It's one of those weird. does that sound right? And it was 100,000 years ago, but I had gone out to eat some, I had gone to this Orthodox Jewish vegetarian restaurant, and I had had split pea soup, but I got really sick from it. So I got back to the show. I had an interview with the Christian Science Monitor, which is a really great newspaper.
It is.
Like politically very neutral and really much more fair than even my favorite newspaper.
Which is?
Well, the New York Times. But I get most of my news from my computer, actually, at this point. But I do love the New York Times. Anyway, the Christian Science Monitor. So I had this interview, and I was sick. I got food poisoning. I tried to throw up before the interview, and I didn't quite succeed, but I smelled my vomit. My eyes were bloodshot, and I did this interview, but I was trying to tell the person, I'm not bulimic, I just need to tell you that, because I smelled and looked horrible. So I finally did manage to vomit after the show, and it cleared me up. But we then went on stage, and I remember that night, it was near the end of the set, and maybe it's because I had gone through this kind of whatever, almost
cathartic,
almost ritualistic catharsis, yeah, beforehand that nobody knew about. But there was a point when the audience stood up and screamed all at one time, and I actually felt the air in the room move from that. And it was in 28 years of performing, one of the most powerful moments. I'll never forget. I was actually speechless. Hard to imagine in this interview that I didn't have anything to say, but I had nothing. It was just so shocking.
Reveals a picture in reverse.
I feel like in 2008, having been through what we've been through under the Bush administration and with the Reagan years and Bush Senior in the 1980s and the early 90s, I think we maybe have found ourselves a candidate in Barack Obama who might actually better represent this country in the 21st century. And I would love for his presidency to be the flip side of what the first decade of the 21st century is represented, the first obviously being 9/11. I'd like to have something a little more positive at the end of the first decade of the 21st century, something that moves us forward with hope. Chinese.